What is the best evangelistic resource that God has ever given us? You know, it's probably not the latest Christian resource that came in the post the other week that you spent $100 on. It's probably not even the latest book that's been published on evangelism or how to share the gospel. I reckon the best evangelistic tool that God's given us is something completely different. What do you reckon it is? It might be the tongue. This thing here. See, we need the tongue, don't we, to share the gospel? We need the tongue to persuade people of the truth. We need the tongue to answer people's questions about Christianity. We need the tongue to tell people the news of Jesus' death. And certainly when Jesus rose from the dead, that was the time to go and tell the world this wonderful news. We need the tongue. And the university is a great environment. It's almost conducive to exploring ideas and discussing things. So the tongue is a great tool to have. But I don't think it's the best tool. Sometimes the tongue can be the very undoing of people. Sometimes the tongue can be too clever, too quick, and even a little bit too proud. I think there's another tool that God has given us. And if you're not very good at speaking or articulate, then you can take heart and be encouraged by this, because there's another tool that God has given us that I reckon is the best. The best evangelistic tool is this thing over here, the ear. See, God has given us the ear to listen to people. And when we listen to people, we can find out where they're coming from. We can find out what issues they are struggling with. We can find out what objections they have got. The best evangelistic tool is the ear, because that enables us to listen, hear. It enables us to show love and care for them. We're not just treating people as a project, we are treating people as a person. We value their opinions. And when we listen with our ears and convey genuine interest and love for people, guess what happens? They start to want to listen to us. And so as we use our ear more, we get to use our tongue even more, because they've been valued and so they want to listen to us. So next time you do some evangelism on the campus, try using your ears first and then see how that creates some wonderful opportunities to use your tongue. The best evangelistic tool is not the tongue, it's the ears.